So yeah, specifically the resolution that I'm using for this project is 384 by 512, which is a 3:4 aspect ratio, with the longer dimension of 512, of course. And yeah, so I don't know why it's it keeps doing that, but yeah, you can just specify the width and height if you want to go for the exact width and height if you want to go for a fixed resolution, or you can just specify the aspect ratio. So like, yeah, so I tend to use the fixed aspect ratio, but you can also just use like a free aspect ratio, which is sometimes nice for dev purposes because then, you know, it'll make it as big as your screen can accommodate. Yeah. Oh, haha. So that's the thing about aspect ratios in Unity. But yeah, maybe that wasn't even the question. So if the So yeah, I haven't actually shipped to, or I haven't like actually compiled for iPad yet. So I haven't actually put my games on an iPad yet. However, from my understanding, the process goes a little bit like you. Okay, so like you develop the project using whatever development environment. For example, Unity is my current development environment. And then in build settings, you can select iOS as one of your target platforms, and you can you know there are like various settings, and yeah, oh, yeah, okay, right. Sorry, I'm like half paying attention to chat. I'll pay more attention in a second. Yeah, so when you build using Unity, it'll give you a collection of files which are not actually the app themselves. The collection of files that you get when you build are for an Xcode project. So the part that you have in order to build for iOS, you need to have a Mac, or as we were talking about earlier, I guess you can accomplish it on a virtual machines, but for most intents and purposes, you probably need a Mac, and that's to run Xcode, and Xcode will take the files that Unity generates, and it will actually turn it into the like the application that that iOS devices can run. And I haven't gone through the submission process myself. For the App Store, I've worked on projects that have gone through it, so I've like heard about it. Like, I've heard a lot of the details about it. But yeah, from there, it's like basically about submitting it to Apple and getting it approved and getting it through their certification processes. So, all right, hold on, let me catch up on chat. Yeah. Oh, cool. Oh gosh, I don't know. I don't know good names. I mean, mine's called Hero. My current project is I call it Hero only because I have no clue what to actually call it. And like my previous projects, they're on my website. Grav was the first one, and Bbox was the second one. So I basically just decided I'll just give all of my projects will just have a 3-letter code name, and I'll figure out real names down the line at some point. But Hex Battle, I like Hex Battle. Hex Battle has like a ring to it. If it's not Taken, I don't know. I don't know. I almost want to say like there might be another game out there with that name, just because like it does have a ring to it. Like it sounds like it could be a game. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Light Up Man said the same thing, or he said he also said he liked Hex Battle. Oh, cool. Yeah, that sounds like a cool project. You said you're making it in Unity. Are you, is it just you working on the project, or are you working with a team? Yeah, I was just saying earlier, one of the things I really like about streaming is that I get to hear about like all these cool I just get to hear from other game devs, 'cause like, I guess it makes sense. Like the people who enjoy game dev streams the most are the people who also themselves develop games. Kind of like the other people who enjoy game streams are the people who themselves play games. So, oh, this thing again. I don't know what that means. For some reason, when I pause the game, dust gets weird. might have something to do with how I'm using the UI system. Hopefully it's only an editor thing and not like, hey, new follower. Hold on, I have to cheat on this one. Anders 27. Yeah, the text is really small on my screen. Sometimes I can't actually read it in the tiny view. But thank you for following and thank you for tuning in. It is a pleasure to have you here. Oh, cool. Yeah, same here. Solo dev. Yeah, I've been really enjoying it. It's just kind of like freeing to. Oh, cool. Thank you. Thank you, Lyra. Eanders. thank you for tuning in. I hope I can do something interesting, make it worth your while. right now we're playing through and we're using our power ups. So range, I'll put on auto attack, speed, bombs, power, bombs, power, bombs, dash. Yeah, cool. so if for anyone who hasn't seen the project run before, the gist is that you are like the titular hero, and your goal is basically like to keep the field clear as possible. Most of the mobs are actually harmless. They'll approach, and they're carrying these like little coins. Sometimes I'll call them cookies. If you hear me talking about cookies, I'm talking about the little yellow things that you collect from the mobs. Others, however, carry explosive devices, and so. This is the start of the game, so it's pretty casual at first, but as the game progresses, you'll see more and more of these hazards show up. So the things on the Hey Mint Arcade, welcome back. Things are going pretty well. I have no complaints. I mean, I do have a list of features that I need to implement, but no complaints from me personally, so yeah. For the people who haven't seen the game before, what's happening on this top bar is that as I clear out the field, as I collect coins and as I get points, I get these power ups that appear on the top bar, and there are several different kinds. Like some of the first ones that I got are these ones down here. These ones are like powers. Like so now, because I got them, I have the ability to drop bombs, and I have the ability to like dash a distance, and I was gonna increase the range of dash. All right, hold on, sorry, I'm gonna make a note to myself. Increase distance of dash. These are powers that I got from this top bar. But the other thing you can get that are actually like stacking up at this point are modifiers. So, for example, here's a multiplicity modifier. If I drop it on bombs, now whenever I activate bombs, there are actually two separate detonations that happen like in rapid sequence. So if I add range to this icon in the corner, it's supposed to represent the hero. I don't know if it's doing that effectively, but if I drop modifiers there, it makes the hero himself more powerful, so I could put a speed modifier on dash, and now dash recharges a little bit faster. I can use it more often. I can put multiplicity on dash, and now when I use dash, I'll dash twice. I can put strength on bombs, so now when my bombs detonate, they blow dudes even higher into the air. Oh, whoops, hold on. I got distracted. I forgot. Like I'm in the habit of dragging the icons because that's how I designed it in the first place. But you can also like click once and then click again to put things. But, hey, when you got a new follower, I'm gonna mispronounce it. Irrevendant. I'm sorry. I'll pronounce it better in a second. Wait, I can do it now. I can step away from the game for a second. Oh no, I can't because I took too long and it went away. But thank you for. Thank you for following. Thank you for tuning in. It's great to have you here. I say that to everybody because it's literally great to have all of you here. I spent all summer like basically doing the exact same thing except without streaming, and it was way less fun. Like some days I couldn't even like. Some days I would just get like so bored that I would just get like distracted by the internet all day, and I was like, you know what? If I'm gonna get distracted by the internet, I might as well invite the internet to come be distracted with me. So, yeah. Thank you, everyone. I was probably talking about something before I got distracted about that. But I was probably talking about modifiers, right? You can okay, so now I have like now I have all three powers, as you notice. This bottom bar is all full up. So the game's basically about it's about like I mean, it has like a light like so it has like light strategy elements in that like you're basically trying to like keep on top of the field to make sure that you don't get overwhelmed. And I've been increasing the pace of the gameplay. As you can see, it plays out pretty fast at this point. We're actually pretty close to the end. Like, I guess one full playthrough is probably going to be about like how long has that taken? Like, apart from the breaks, I think it took us probably about like what was that, like 6 minutes or so, 6 or 7 minutes. I usually try and aim for about that time range. It's like so the game gets pretty fast, and it's kind of a one of the challenges to it actually is keeping on top of your power-ups, because I just recently increased the rate at which explosive devices spawn, and it's definitely noticeable because the game is now in fact getting quite steep. I barely have time to actually use these power-ups. Oh, cool! I think we're getting close to the end of the game, so we should be wrapping it up pretty soon. Oh yeah, I just realized something. They're all gonna have explosive devices right at the end of the game. It's kind of terrifying. But I do, I actually, maybe that's fine. Maybe I don't have to change that, but I could do something to change that if I wanted to. All right, cool. Hey, Dias Distorted, how's it going? Welcome back, long time no see. as part of my grand plans as a supervillain, I'm nearing the completion of phase three, wherein I invent a hero. I don't have the entire plan worked out exactly, but I'll figure the rest of it as I go. We're pretty close to this. Like, we're making progress on this project. It's like, I like a few weeks ago I said that this is it was basically feature complete, and like that's pretty close to true. Like, it might, like, we're adding little things here and there. We're adding like just like little tweaks, little tuning refinements and stuff. But I mean, we're I don't know. It's just a funny feeling because, like, as I mentioned a few times, I've been working on this project for a while. What the heck is happening? Oh, I see what happened. All right, that's kind of funny. Wait, why is he? Oh, yeah. I need to increase the hero's starting range because I increased the radius. I increased the mob radius, so now I need to give him higher starting range, or else he'll just like keep. R he'll just keep like, just kind of like, just kind of like, I don't know. Just kind of like, whoa. Oh, I clearly did not reset a value, because that's way too many explosive devices. There should not be this many explosive devices so soon in the game. I don't think. Oh, I'm probably not clearing the backstock of charges, because they seem to have slowed down, but they were going way too fast at first. All right. Right. So on restart. End game. What would it be called? Bomb charge. Oh, well, no, not really. That's not the same thing, but that is in fact related. EXPL spawn stock, yeah, equals 0. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's what I was not doing. Let's double check. Yeah, that was totally it. All right, well, that's good. I might keep that. I might, my first thought was like, that's gonna get ridiculous, but also, that's during like the, what were we calling it? Like the victory rush or whatever. And the hero gets really powerful during the victory rush, so yeah, maybe we just keep that, I guess. I don't know. I'll keep an eye on it. I might want to tune it down at some point, but yeah, I guess we'll find out. I feel like things were getting. No, I guess that was pretty good. I think that was pretty good how it played out. I think I'm gonna actually increase the number of mobs altogether in the game because at the end of the game, everything goes by really fast. So like the difference between like 500 and like 800 is gonna be a relatively slight distance difference because when you get that high in numbers, like you're gonna be chewing through them like super fast. And the end game goes by really fast is the other feeling. Like I mean, I guess that's kind of the note that I wrote to myself is that there's a slight lull in the early mid game versus frantic end game. But maybe it's not even the fact that the end game is frantic. Maybe it just feels imbalanced because you only stay there for a touch. So I don't know. I want to try seeing what that does. Oh yeah. I did just change. That does have some bearing on that has a fair amount of bearing on this balance value here. Yeah. Oh yeah, man. Feels like a while ago. I guess it was like 4 hours ago, but yeah. yeah. So yeah, at the end of the game, at the end of the game, basically everything goes berserk. Like everything is like maximally, not literally maximally powerful, but pretty close to like maximally powerful, including the enemies. The enemies are just like the enemies go into like super death mode too. So I think that, I mean, and we made it through. Like it didn't. Like it got super intense and like all of a sudden all of the mobs were carrying bombs, but we survived it, so oh. You know what we never changed was the explosive spawn min rate. Min period. Which is 0.1 seconds. We might want to make it slightly more than 0.1 seconds. Like maybe like 0.2 seconds. Let's see. Because I want it to go insane, but we just made the game a lot longer, so we don't want it to go completely insane. Yeah, let's see how this feels, just as a comparison. This might not be correct. It might have been more correct at point one, but yeah, let's just have a just for another point of comparison. Let's see how this goes. And actually, you know what? I think actually, so sorry, I'm gonna switch over to face cam for a minute. Oh, cool. Yeah, speaking of how naked I am, sorry, I'll address the full question in a second, but speaking of how naked I am, I'm gonna switch over to face cam for a minute because I don't know, it weirds me out. I just don't like uploading stuff to my website on camera. But I'm gonna upload this build to I'm gonna build the project and then I'm going to upload it to the site so that you guys, if you want, you can check out a more current version. Part of the reason I'm doing that is because I don't know. I feel like getting out of Unity for a second. But another reason is because it's getting. I don't know. I feel like we're making like really good progress, and like I'm actually like each time I play through the game, I'm coming up with like fewer and fewer things to like find about the game. So if you guys want to start like yeah, if you guys want to start getting in on this action, I mean you've been giving great feedback, so I'd be very interested to hear what you have to say. Hold on, let me just make sure the well, no, I guess The two builds are so similar, I probably won't even tell the difference if, it'll take me a minute to. What's a good way to tell the difference? I get, through the gameplay, it'll become apparent pretty fast. So, oh, wait, no, I should do something. I should, sorry, I forgot, I'm on FaceTime, so I should get through this pretty fast so that you don't have to stare at my, all this business for much longer. But, yeah, because sometimes if I upload the new build, it just goes to like sometimes a web browser will cache the old version, and so I have a way to get around that. I'll just upload it to what? I'll just cut this. Sorry, this will not take especially long. It'll take not much longer, in fact. All right, so we have call this P4. P4. Right, and then so P3. P3 was like yesterday's build, kind of. Or not yesterday's, but wait, where am I? oh right, wrong project. Hero build P3. SRSLY.PZ hero P3. And then right, okay, so P4. So that's P3. Sorry. Update this with this. Yes, and then add a new directory for P4. All right. So hypothetically, if you go to the if you go to the site, so yeah. If you yeah, thank you. Yeah, hypothetically, if you go to that link now, oops, sorry. I realize that that's a lot less appropriate when I'm on face cam. Sorry. Hypothetically, if you go to that link, it could give you the new build. But if you've been to that link recently, it might give you it might have cached the old version, and so it might give you the old version. In order to get to a little bit of both, yes. So for one, sorry. Actually, hold on. I'm just gonna wrap this up real quick so I can get off of face cam. All right, there we go. All right, so yeah, standing desk, and I'm standing on a small exercise device, so that adds like a few inches as well. And then I also just have low ceilings. So, all right, yeah. If you try srsly.bz/hero, that could be the new version. As I've mentioned, some browsers will cache it, so this you could get the old version if you. If you think you're getting the old version, like if you don't see the right like pacing changes and stuff that we implemented today, then if you go to P4, if you go to HTTP, this link will definitely give you the new version. This is the new version of the game. All right, so all right, hold on, let me catch up on chat now. So I'm not constantly naked. For example, like I'm wearing earbuds now, so that almost counts as clothing. I learned to code in college, I guess. Fun fact, I originally wanted to study web development, but I was late to register for one of my courses, and it filled up, and because of the way the schedule works, like there's like a very small sorry, this is a tangent. There's a very small like web development curriculum, and so like they weren't offering the course again for like a really inconvenient amount of time, and it was a prerequisite, and so like I literally would have had to delay my entire like graduation schedule by a year just to stick with it. So I was like, eh, I'll just do like I don't know, I'll just do like computer programming instead. So the fun fact about Hero, sorry, these are like DS Distorted, you like triggered all of my like fun anecdotal stories with your questions. Fun fact about Hero is that it's actually a remake of the first game project that I ever started on when I was like professionally, I guess. I mean, it was before I had my like my first industry gig, and I never actually even finished the first version of Hero, and I never actually like published it or nothing ever really came of it. But I it was the first thing that I'd made, and this is like this is like a return to my roots, like to I mean, I've changed like so much of it. It's a much different product than it had been originally, but same kind of thing. So that was like the first project I worked on, and then oh yeah, so I didn't finish the project. I instead leveraged it to get a gig in AAA, and then I worked in AAA for 6 years, and I worked at Harmonix Music Systems. We made so the games I worked on there were like Rock Band, Dance Central. We did a mobile device called VidRhythm, or a mobile app called VidRhythm. I worked on that. We did a few other titles here and there too. So yeah, that was my professional career. And then most recently, I put together the games that are on my website as like a few portfolio pieces. The link to my website, you've probably seen it already, but it's like right underneath. All right. So yeah. Oh, right. So these current projects, these three like Grav, Bebox, and Hero, I'm working almost entirely independently. Like, I mean, I of course get feedback from people who play the title, and I really appreciate like the stuff you guys say and have to say about the title based on trying it. I really appreciate that. It's awesome. I actually can't thank you enough. But other than that, it's just me. And so yeah, I'm kind of putting them together as like portfolio pieces, so, like as examples of like these are the things that I make independently. Yeah. Oh, so actually, but the next project that I'm working on, you literally like triggered all of my anecdotal or like all of my tangent stories. I have a lot of them. It's actually not hard to trigger them. The next project that I'm working on is actually going to be a bot for Twitch, and one of the things that, like, I was tempted actually just to get to like sign up or like hook up like Nightbot or like one of the currently available bots just to get, and maybe I even should do that. But I as soon as next week and maybe even like on Saturday, I'm gonna start working on this bot project and. So it will ideally it will it will be able to one of its functions in chat will be to answer like frequently asked questions. I'm also thinking of like one of the things I do that like probably the number one question is hi, I'm new, what is this project? And so I tend to do like a spin through the project, and like right now, yeah, no, you know, it's pretty convenient right now. If I'd been thinking about it sooner, or like the next time I embark on a project like this and do it live on stream, I'm probably going to set up like just like a quick like 2 minute YouTube video of like here's the project, basically the same 2 minute spiel that I keep giving, but I'm going to set it up as something that the chat bot can point people towards, and that way, yeah, that way, regardless of what I'm working on, it'll be easy to really like show and to show people like what the project is about, and then I can keep that hypothetically. I can update that video over the course of the project so it stays fairly current. All right, I'm still catching him on chat though, so hold on. Yeah, the whole game will hopefully feel more like a. Yeah, with the current version, like the P4, I might just be talking to myself here. Maybe everyone has is left and has gone to play the game. Actually, that'd be I wouldn't mind that. I'd be okay with that. but for those of you who are still listening, then yeah, the so basically everything we've been doing the past like so like today and on Tuesday have just been to make the game like. At the start of the week, well, so on Monday I did the icon art, which, yeah. But anyways, okay, cool. Sorry, I don't mean to distract you. So yeah, I so the icon art, but yeah. So once we finished that, the game was essentially feature complete, and we've just spent. It's been about like, I think we've done about like 8 or 9 hours at this point of just like balance passes. So yeah, on at the start of day Tuesday, like all the systems were implemented. But like they were all just like they were all implemented like independently, kind of like I mean I kept the game like quasi-balanced just so that it, you know, things weren't literally ridiculous during development. But like it didn't feel like a game. It felt like we just felt very disjoint. And so now like we've spent the past 9 hours of dev time, just gelling it all together, adding in like whatever small like micro features would. Yeah, you beat my score. What was mine? It was like, I forget. I wrote it down somewhere. Yeah. Yep. Wow. That is impressive. I've been playing this game for like months. I need to step up my game, I guess. Sorry. So I plan on working a bit more today, and then oh cool. Yeah, I'm probably gonna just sorry before I get to your question. I'm probably gonna keep balancing this game, and like I don't plan on I plan on wrapping this game at least by the end of Saturday, and I don't know. I might wrap it even sooner than that. And like none of these, like Bbox, Grav, and Hero, none of them are finished. I plan on they're all still active products. In fact, except for the fact that I'm going to do the October challenge first and make that bot that I was telling you about. I still plan on going back and updating Bbox and Grav too. I have just a few things that I'd like to change about those products, and maybe if after I update those, maybe I'll go back and then update Hero again based on like whatever new information or like, you know, sometimes if you just get distance from a project, it becomes a lot clearer what you need to change about the project. So, yeah. 6 years, 6 long years. Yeah, like my the what interests me about game development is like the technical design. One of the things that I don't know. Yeah, you said you're just getting started. 3 years in college, working on this stuff. Yeah. One of the things that became really apparent to me in bigger organizations is that, well, I mean, just like, so like there are departments and like, just the way like it's practical for a business to manage its human capital is not necessarily like, I don't know. They're like, some of the lines and distinctions feel like a little bit arbitrary. There's so like I worked at like a fairly large company. Like it was like at its height it was like over 300 employees, but like it was never fewer than like 120 or so. And like just with that number of people, like there's tribal cultures like within the company culture. And like yeah, I don't know. Well, so long story short, the thing that interests me the most is like the bridges between groups that can get somewhat like segmented. So for example, like engineering and design like are both so critical to like the success of a product. Like without good engineering, you're not gonna have an impressive title. Without good design, you're not gonna have a fun title. And in order to like really like come up with like a great title, I think you know there has to be like a great deal of interplay between those disciplines. And so yeah, the thing I like the most is basically like that like cross section. Like I don't consider myself an engineer. I'll program only because it's like the most effective way to get my ideas onto like a digital canvas. And so yeah, super long story. Super long, but to TLDR it, I guess. Technical design, I guess, is I don't know if I could call it like a specialty, but it's definitely like what what drives me. It's like why I work in games. Oh no. Oh man, I like how I just spent like 5 minutes responding to the first half of your question, and then I read through to read that you. Yeah, no, I should learn how to answer quickly, but I do answer questions quicker the more I'm asked, so if that counts for anything. Oh, yeah, sure. Well, as you can probably tell, I like answering questions like this, so feel free to ask in chat or wherever. I get pretty long-winded. But it's good because I mean, part of the reason I get distracted by stuff like this is because, like, if I slam my head against the same thing for too, I mentioned this a few times before, like, it's good to keep perspective, and so I try and keep my nose to the grindstone, but I also like talking about relevant things. I feel is like probably the best way to distract yourself. Like, just yeah, like just talking about the yeah, leaderboards. I should add leaderboards to all of my games, in fact. They're all points-based. I have not done that for any of them. And but those are like kind of the features that like there's nothing original about a leaderboard. Like, everyone knows what a leaderboard does. And so that's actually the reason why I haven't added them to my games yet, because like I mean, like, Heroes gotten a bit bigger in scope than I anticipated in the first place, but they were all supposed to be very, very quick projects just to prove out a gameplay idea. And I think Grav and Bbox were very successful in that regard, and then Hero has gotten, well, Hero's become what we have before us now. So yeah, I think right, yeah, so right. So I keep saying like these games are, when I call these games like done, quote unquote, what I really mean is they're like at about 80%, and so like the other 20% is like I need to tune them up for their given platforms to make sure that they don't just technically run on that platform, but they're actually like suited for that platform. There's a lot of like asset art that goes into like the App Store and the marketplace and like banner art and copy. Like, you have to write like a synopsis of your product to try and sell it and use like good keywords for search engine optimization and all that good stuff. And then like I mean, and then when you're actually like making a release like that, then you have to really start taking seriously the PR as well, because like it's nice to release a product, but if you actually want people to notice it and if you actually want people to play it, then it's important to like message it as well. So I mean, that part's not literally game development, so I guess I wouldn't c consider that part of the other 20%. But I mean, it's definitely something that's mandatory, or you know, pretty prudent. And then so then what else? Like save data. Like there's a bunch of things that, like, every time you refresh the app or refresh the website, it's just gonna start from the blank canvas, which is fine for like a lot of the games, but for Bbox, for example, you can customize your deck. Like, you can get rid of the S blocks, that's a popular one. You can get rid of you can like tune up, what is it? No, I think it's, yeah, I think like this is the build that I usually use, pro tip. But like, for example, if I reload the page now, it'll have gone right back. So like, yeah, little things like that. There's nothing new or inventive about that, and I don't feel like I need those to show what I'm attempting to show with my portfolio. But they're like, you know, they're part of that 100%. Like, they're mandatory in order to get to 100%. Like, I consider them vital parts of games. They're just not what I'm showing off with this portfolio. So, personally, like, none of my personal projects are on the App Store. My experience releasing projects for those platforms has been in my AAA experience. I actually, I guess I've never really done one for the Android store, but we did VidRhythm for the iOS. So yeah, actually, I was working on like the platform integration team for VidRhythm. which was kind of cool. I feel like I mean, like, that was a while ago. That was like a few years back, but at the time I really had to study up on like the, what is it, the ARGs, Apple Release Guidelines, and the HIGs, the Human Interface Guidelines. So yeah, so whatever of these projects I decide to like, yeah, so my goal after I finish these projects and participate in all of these game jams that I'm participating in. Oh yeah, I'm just gonna mention it because why not? The weekend of the 18th and the 19th, I'm going to game jam. It's local, but it's so like a I think it's called the Purple Monkey Game Jam. Some local offices are hosting for the weekend. So I'm oh, I got permission from the organizers to live stream the whole thing. So well, I'll live stream like my participation in the event. So I'm probably gonna do like a crazy stream that weekend. I don't know if I'm gonna do like a crazy marathon stream, but it could happen. I don't know exactly. It depends on how the event is organized. If it's like an overnight thing, I might do a crazy marathon stream all through Saturday and Sunday. But either way, it should be interesting. Oh yeah. Yeah. That's a good point. I should get like a if I release a game, I would want also to get a Twitch channel for that game, so that way people could stream the game like under the correct header. Although then I'd have to actually come up with a title, because it's not going to be called Hero. It's not like the Hero channel on Twitch. It's going to be, I don't know. Oh man, how am I ever going to come up with a real title for these? I have no clue. Sorry, I'm reading chat. Burning World. Oh, cool. This is one of your previous projects, or one of the, or the project that you're working on now? Sorry, I'm loading it up on my other screen. I should add this to my list of, okay, I'm gonna add this to my list of bookmarks because it's gonna be super boring to see me quietly sit and look at another screen where you can see, none of you can see what is going on. And oh, cool. Yeah, that's awesome. Thank you for sharing that. Yeah, it's cool to see what everyone else is working on too, because like now that I've been, you know, doing like 30 hours a week streaming, I have less time to check out other things. Because like if I wasn't streaming right now, I would still be working, but instead of chatting with you guys, I would just be like intermittently browsing the internet. So I miss out on a lot of that because of this, but I don't miss it. I just yeah, I'll have to check that out later. Yeah. Dude. Yeah, please do. Yeah, I super I would encourage everyone to share the stuff that they're working on or the stuff that they like in the chat. The one thing I'd like to ask though is that if please don't like if you're gonna promote something, like I've been saying, it means a lot to me that you guys are here watching. So like, please don't promote things that would prevent people from, or like would conflict with people watching. So like if, yeah, I mean like I try and wait, what? Oh, and the platformer? Sorry, I haven't played it yet. I thought you were just referring to that the fact that the backdrop of Hero was flat red. Sorry, I don't understand what he's saying because I haven't seen the game yet. Okay, you see, have a nice meal. See you in a bit. Oh man. Sorry, just a minor aside. The other day, some of you might have been here for it, but there was like a apparently there was like an argument that went on in chat, but it went on. I still don't even know what language it was in. I know it was a language that I don't understand, and like people got really offended about it. And one of like my followers, who had been like a really cool person and was like really cool, just like unfollowed and left, and I haven't seen them again since. So like now I'm like really paranoid whenever people in chat, with like I don't understand what's going on, I get paranoid about it because I'm like, oh God, everyone's gonna leave forever. Oh sweet. All right, I'm adding this one to the list as well. Oh yeah, actually, I just remembered something. I haven't started doing it yet because, but like, oh yeah. So I've been exporting these Twitch archives videos for like a little while, but then they get deleted. I've been exporting these videos to YouTube. And one of the things I want to start doing is I want to thank you. Yeah, I will play after, immediately after. One of the things so one of the things I want to do for when I export to YouTube, just as a convenience factor, is to include in the description all of the relevant links that have been discussed, like over the course of the stream, so that way when people go back to watch the videos on YouTube, they don't have to like read the tiny text in the corner of like the chat box in the screen just to like find out that the links are, just have them convenient. So would it be all right if I include these links in like the video notes, that way people who watch the video can check them out as well? I'm hoping that's okay, just because like, you know, if it's relevant to conversation, then cool. Oh yeah, I still have to figure out how to do that. I should. Sometimes I'll like every night. A lot of time when I'm not streaming, I'll watch like other people's streams because I enjoy seeing what other people are doing. That's part of why I got into it in the first place. Sometimes I'll go back and watch my own streams, and that's sometimes terrifying. But yeah, no, I haven't started pulling out highlights yet, but I should do that. Oh, I forgot to change the hero's range. The hero's starting range has to go higher so that he doesn't like jitter up against his targets. Mobs range init. So we'll just put you up to like 2 for starters. Oh, are allies gonna do that weird thing too? Probably, right? Alright, the hero stopped doing it, probably. Yeah, hero stopped doing it. What about allies? Would allies do it? I feel like they probably will. Homeless flood the board. Oh, cool. All right. That sounds simple enough. All right, yeah. I started using the video manager, but I guess I still don't know exactly. Wow. Today's stream is like a gold mine of like cool stuff. So yeah, I hope it's okay with people, but if like the links that go up in chat, I'd like to include those in the video notes when we export them. So I'm not like reaching a broad audience there yet, but you know, it's like publicly accessible on the internet, so I just want to mention that in case anyone had qualms about it. It basically would just be presented like as such. I mean, kind of like how the like all the chat shows up in the window here. So it'll just be, I basically just wanted to put it in the video notes so that way the oh yeah, the allies definitely do the jittery thing. So let's increase their range as well. Mobs range, I guess 2. Yeah, 2's probably just fine. Yeah. Sure. Why not? Video manager highlight. That's cool. Yeah. I mean, I like that. I heard a cool statistic. I don't know if it's true, but I heard that like 60 hours of 60 hours of video content gets uploaded to YouTube every second. Every second of every day, 60 hours of content gets uploaded. I don't know if that's true, but I don't know. It seems true enough. I just like that there's just so much there. So like, despite the fact that I'm like cranking out like 30 hours of video a week, it's like, pff, sure, yeah, whatever, just upload it. Yeah. Pretty cool. I don't know. That's just my tangent. Oh, you know what? I'm sorry. I'm slightly peckish. I haven't eaten in a while. I'm the new yeah, I know, right? Isn't that crazy? There's just so many people using it that I'm just gonna have a snack. I hope you guys don't mind. It's just a bit of tomato juice. I'm getting to that point where like my brain is exerting more inf or my stomach is exerting more influence over my actions than my brain, so. So yeah, let's keep at this. We had a nice chat. Thank you again for everyone who had stuff to share. Increase distance of dash. Yeah, I tend to forget that. No, not mobs range, power range. So it starts at 4. Starts at 4. I mean, it'll still only increase by 1 each time. But I guess that's fine. I'll start it at 5 instead. Just so it feels significant. Even with the. We reduced its radius, so. I don't think this will make it as powerful as when it had a bigger radius, but it will make it at least feel like more is happening. And it will scale better too, so. Alright, yeah. Let's give this a couple more shakes. I keep wanting to just be like, oh, it's good enough. It's good enough. I'll just ship it now. We're good. we can move on to the next thing. Part of that is because I was feeling slightly hungry, and my brain, or my stomach was trying to convince my brain that we needed to go obtain food. Oh yeah, I should be using my power-ups. Speed on bombs, power on bombs, power on bombs, range on auto attack. Dash, multiplicity on hero. Speed on dash. Yeah. I don't know. I guess yeah. We're probably getting to a pretty good spot with the game. But there are plenty of like. Slightly wonky edges that we can still smooth out. We'll have those for a while to come. All right, phase two. Multiplier on. Oh, range, yeah. Ooh, delicious range. The nice thing about. Pro tip, nice thing about stacking range on the hero is it makes it so that instead of striking a single target, the hero actually strikes multiple targets at a time. They have like a slight AoE effect on their attacks. And that applies to the hero and the allies too, so. Power on bombs, I guess. Actually, I should put power on the hero's attack too. Now that it has an AoE effect. So this is pretty good. I might want to tone it. How? I was gonna say tone it down. I might want to tone down the rate at which mobs spawn slightly. Potentially. Yeah, because it felt like. Well, I mean, we already have POW 3, so. And POW 3 works. First time. Cool. Recharge on POW 3? Sure, why not? Yeah, I guess, okay, so yeah, one of the things that's very different this time around is that, the what? The target, the number of target mobs is a lot higher, so, it's gonna take, oh, well, we are already to phase three, but, it's good. Like phase four is gonna take longer, and one of the things I was tempted to say is that, yeah, maybe we can tone down the rate at which mobs spawn in the earlier part of the game because we kind of hit like a we hit a critical mass like prematurely, I felt. And I only mean that necessarily against the curve of the game. I don't necessarily mean that against the challenge of the or like the actual like length of time of the game because yeah, so the two ways to change that would be to either make the mob spawn slower or make the rest of the game progress faster. So power, I was gonna say, I said power, I wanted on auto attack. Speed on, I kind of like POW 3. I used to think POW 3 was like a waste of modifiers, but actually, I think by boosting the effect that modifiers have, I think POW 3 is now relevant. Which is cool. All right, we're in phase four. So we're probably. All right, no, yeah, phase four is probably gonna last longer now. Because that is one thing that it did not previously. Yeah, Path 3 is pretty cool. I think I like it. It took me a while to get there. Because, I don't know. It'd been. Like, it took me so long just to figure out what POW 3 was. For people who've been, like, watching the stream for a while, you'll know that, or you'll remember that, like, POW 3 took so long just to arrive. And then, now, and then, yeah, I guess for a while, so, even once we had it for a while after, it felt like, I don't know, like, maybe it's an imposter of some sort. Like, maybe this isn't really real. Like, just, like, because the other, powers had been implemented for so long, and POW 3 was like so new. Like, I don't know. It definitely hadn't had the same amount of time to gel, and so as a result, it felt much more mere and not irrelevant, but like unimpactful. Like, it wasn't having a major shape on the game, and the game did not really involve much about it. But yeah, I think we're getting there. I might have overdone it, or else I might want to revisit some of the other potential challenge points. Yeah. Oh, you know what I need to do is the detonation radius is still really low, but mobs don't clump as tightly anymore. So as a result, fewer mobs are within the detonation radius at any time. So I'll need to change that. Whoa, that was a bomb. Oh, because we're into the victory march. Yeah, I was like, where did that come from? But yeah, victory march. Get out of here. Get. All right. All right, sorry. Hey, oh yeah, all right, sorry. Sorry, yeah, I was really into the game. If I look away from the game, I start to suck. So sorry. I guess yeah, it's a little tough. Sorry. I'm just failing at chat. But all right, so I get all right. Well, hey, yeah, that's about how much I got. So we're clearly yeah, I'd say point scales in this range are probably pretty good. Although I cheated. I actually since building that version that you were playing, I made it easier to win. So I'm cheating. You probably actually got a higher score than I did, but yeah, so the thing in the corner with the Roman numerals is the phase marker. So it starts out as phase one with Roman numeral one, and then it goes to phase two, phase three, phase four. I added that in because there, well, I mean, I guess it's not really important, and I could probably take it out at this point. I just wanted like some on-screen indicator so that players could tell like how far they were through the game, and like it's not very clearly messaged. So like, yeah, you're probably not really going to pick it up first time through. In fact, maybe I should just take it out because I don't know, like that box other that. So part of the reason I put it in is because I had no clue what to put in that box. Previously, it was going to have like a health meter for the hero, but the hero doesn't have health anymore, so I was really unsure about what to put there. Yeah, so that's why I put it there. Because like literally, if without that, it would just be an empty box. And I guess like I could put like an icon representing the hero in that box, which I guess would probably make more sense, right? So maybe I should do that. Maybe I should replace it. Yeah, I don't know. I like it though. I guess if the user can understand it, I think it could be a neat, a helpful thing to have because like I look at it a lot just to get a sense of, you know, because I know what it is, I look at it a lot to get a sense of how far through the game I am. And if you're curious about the mechanics behind the phases, you reach phase two the first time a mob is freed from the simulation. The first time you knock him off so far into the air that it goes flying off the screen and out of the simulation, then that's the entrance of phase two. And each time you enter a new phase, like everything gets a little bit faster. So phase three, you enter phase three once you've reached 10% of your goal. Once you've knocked 10% of the mobs out of the simulation necessary to reach the to like reach the win condition, yeah, that's when you get that is the entry to phase three, and then entry to phase four is when you've knocked 30% of the mobs out of the simulation. And so even though phase four is actually relatively short, I mean like it doesn't it's about as long as the rest of the phases, but actually you reach 70% of your goal just in phase four, and that's just because of like the way the power balance curves. Like you get really powerful right at the end of the game. So think the game might be slightly too long now. Originally, the goal was 500, and then I kicked it up to 1,000, and I think 800 might be closer to the right answer. So I'm gonna do that. 800, and then what else? Oh, the radius, the detonation radius. Oh no, it's just called min radius, right? Or no, wait. No, what is it? Ex no. Forget what it's called. Maybe. So let's go to explosion spawn time. Oh yeah. So, yeah. Oh, sorry. I only like half caught up on chat. Yikes. Oh, sorry, I was just catching up on chat. Yeah, so explosion stall. Oh no, yeah, no, it'd be it has to be det something, right? It'd have to be det. Cookie det timer. Cookie det duration. Det dash det defer, which is detonation radius. All right. Where is that? Where do you live? Oh, there it is, 5. All right, so yeah, so I should probably put it like 7.5. All right. Yeah, so that should be better. Welcome back, Light Up Man. How's it going? Yeah, we got a little. We had a. It like there's an ebb and flow of the. Of the stream. Apparently, it is a tidal stream. Yeah, when I first started streaming, I would get really nervous whenever chat died down because I'd be like, "What did I do? Did I get boring all of a sudden?" But yeah, no, I don't know. It just seems to be the way of the. We have a lot to talk about, and then we all get distracted by all the things that we chat about, and then it picks up a little while later again. Oops. Whatever. Yeah, so I think things are going pretty well. It's funny. It's like I guess I just have to really change the way I think of work and think of like the goal for the game, because like it used to be like you'd fire up the game and something would go horribly catastrophically wrong. And it became so obvious what had to change. But at this point, things don't go horribly catastrophically wrong anymore. They go like a little bit imperfect. Or I mean like they go like in ways that are not ideal or that you'd want to change, but like I don't know. Like in a lot of ways like I don't get that same sense of like urgency anymore. So it's strange. Like now it's all up to me just to really change my perspective on like what to look for really. Like it's not about those big glaring issues anymore. Now it's about tracking down the minutiae, and because at this point, like if the game is going to if the game won't reach its potential, it's at this point it's because of like 1,000 little things, not because of like any one big thing. So multiplicity on bombs, I guess. Apparently I'm stacking bombs this game. All bombs, all day. It does make for simpler playthroughs. Maybe that's why I keep thinking it feels overpowered. Because, like, if you stack all of your modifiers on one thing, you spend a lot more time looking at the board and a lot less time. Oh, I was going to try slowing down the pace at which the mob growth rate, or to increase the rate of... What would be the opposite of... So I could increase I could slow down the rate at which mobs spawn, or I could increase the rate at which modifiers spawn, possibly. I might want to do that. Maybe. Oh yeah, stack. I should probably make allies more powerful. Right now they're not quite as powerful as the hero, which is not how multiplicity works on any of the other things. On all the other things, the multiplied effects are just as powerful as the initial effects. Although I guess if I wanted to balance that, I could do it more like the I could do it the other way around. I could make the other abilities more like the hero, where multiplicity is not like does not give you truly the same amount. I think I need to tone down just how effective range is in general, because it's really effective. It's just because like you don't need a lot of strength in order to clear the board. As long as you hit like a wide target, then you, as a result, are fairly effective at clearing the board. Like here, for example, like I only have like several points of multiplicity and bomb and several points of range, but I'm just like sweeping it up. Stacking on bombs is a potent strategy right now. So, I should probably address that. And I'm actually now that I think about it, it's probably stacking on basically anything is going to be super effective. That's probably still the case. Although probably not with POW 3. I'm guessing POW 3 shows up so late in the game that like by that point. Well, I should try that. I should see what happens if you stack on POW 3 in the late game. Yeah, I need to tone down range. Range just trivializes the game. It doesn't make you feel more powerful, it just makes the game feel impotent, basically. And I guess actually that makes POW 3 more relevant, because POW 3 is like one of the great effectors of range. The way it works currently, for every point of range or strength you put into POW 3, it increases the range and strength of all of your other abilities and the hero by a comparable amount. Oh, I think we're at the victory march. Or the victory rush. Boom. Hey, I got a higher score that time. So I guess that would imply that stacking on bombs is OP. Oh, sorry. Thank you. Thank you, Mentor Kate. Yeah, one of the nice things about Twitch is that when you click on links, it doesn't close the window that you're in. It opens it in a new window, which or like a new tab or whatever, which is nice. So yeah, because of that, like I like when people are chatting and having a good time. And you can go check out other stuff and still hear me like prattling in the background. So yeah. Stacking bombs, yeah. All right, so yeah, I clearly have to tone that down. And not because I don't want bombs to be powerful. Bombs will always be powerful because they're your best method of pinpointing an explosive device. The thing that I'm seeing with too much range though is that you don't have to target anymore. You can just hit in general and everything will explode. Oops, not mobs range. Power range, yeah. So yeah, I did increase the. Actually, yeah. Okay, so I'll actually bump up the range slightly. Oh. Wait, range on power 3 starts at 3. What does strength start at? Starts at 1. Ooh. I might want to change that. Yeah, I want to change that. I'm going to start it at 1. And then, so power 3 will be less powerful initially, but it will get more powerful faster if you stack on it. Maybe I shouldn't change it at this point. Hold on, I'm gonna put it back to 2 and put strength to 2. Cause I don't know, I was starting to like it, so I don't wanna just Oh wait, and it increments by Ooh. Wait a second. Am I calculating that correctly? Cause it really actually all right, I'm putting it back to how it started. I'm gonna look up what I'm doing because it might be that I'm. It might be that if I did my math wrong, it might be that strength has very little effect on super, and it has, and range has tons of effect on super. So let's see how I'm calculating that. Super mod. Find references. Whoa. Oh yeah, there are a lot of references to super mod. All right. Super mod equals. Supermod strength times ooh, yeah. I'm doing this way wrong. So, ugh. All right, wait, hold on. What do I actually want to do? Oh wow. Yeah, no, I'm doing this super wrong. Strength is like basically nothing on super, but range does. Too much, way too much. All right, so that's good to have found. So yeah, what's a better way to do this? I guess. Huh. Super mod strength. No, there's not really a good way to do this. Man. Oh, well. I could just fundamentally change how strength works, or fundamentally change how range works. All right, let's see how I'm using power strength. This should be simple enough, actually. Because everywhere I'm using power strength, there is a modifier value there. So, yeah. All right. So, yes, that is all accurate. All right, yeah, I'm using it very few places. So, Supermod times power strength and lit. Yeah, whew. Good times. All right, so that can stay the same. That can all stay the same. Victory Rush, Dash Explosion Force. All right, so Dash Explosion Force and I think Explosion Force is the other one. All right, Dash Explosion Force and Explosion Force have to get divided by 5. Explosion Force. Oh wow, it's already like 18. 18 divided by 5 is like. Is what? It's like 0.03 something. 0.033-ish. Wow, that's a very small number. And then, so Explosion Force, yeah. And then, what was the other one? Dash Explosion Force. 0.2, oh, that's easier. Divided by 5 is 0.04. Oh wait, no, it wouldn't be 0.33, it'd be 0., like, 3.6. Yeah, 0.36. Alright, save that. Oh wait, but now, okay, now we have to do the other thing to strength. Right, so these all go to 5, 5, 5, and 1. Oh. No, wait, no. No, this can be 5-5 and 1. 5-5, 1, and 1. And then also, and now range can be 1 as well. Alright, so what I just did is I wanted to equalize the increment value. This fourth value in these arrays, like there are only three powers, but the fourth value in these arrays are the degrees to which the other things increment when a modifier is applied to them. And previously, so the way Supermod, the way the amount of increased power you get from using POW 3 is calculated was just additive between POW 3 strength and POW 3 range. But POW 3 strength and POW 3 range are on very grossly different scales, so I put them on the same scale. So now we can just do that. I could have instead just changed the way Supermod was calculated, but those numbers were all arbitrary, and I don't know, it just feels cleaner to have them on the same scale anyways, so yeah. And in fact, I think, oh yeah, so I was going to, right, so the, so that, so wait, what do I have to do to Supermod now? Anything? Yeah, because it won't be as powerful to start with anymore. Which I guess is okay. I guess that's actually fine, actually. So instead of one, I'll do two and two, and we'll probably have to now we'll probably have to tune. What's it called? Super mod strength. How's that gonna change? It used to be three and one. Oh, and now it's two and two. So that's fine. All right, so actually maybe that's fine. Maybe that'll all resolve itself magically and correctly. But I mean I want to put more in I want to investigate Power 3 further because I'm curious to know what happens if you do stack on Power 3. It's something that I haven't tried before because it I don't know for whatever reason it just always in my mind. I was just like, well, I talked enough about that earlier. I don't have to rehash all of it, but yeah. So yeah. The time is now creeping up on 8 o'clock. I started streaming at 2:30, and I don't know. I probably won't go all the way to 10:30. I was saying I would go to 10:30 if I put in 8 hours, or I mean that's just how the math works out. So yeah, I'm not in. I don't plan on stopping anytime super soon, but I mean, I probably will at some point. Yeah, I just I don't know. I think it's the quality of the I think it's like the type of work that we're doing. So, oh yeah, okay, yeah. So the build that's on the build that's on the website too, that's gonna have broken. That's gonna have broken Pow 3 because of the it won't have the change that we just made. So now if you stack on Pow 3 like in this current build that we just put together, thank you for trying that by the way. Yeah, and I think that's why I'd been averse to it, 'cause like probably in the back of my mind I probably knew like the math wasn't gonna work out very well, and it was and Pow 3 was gonna be not stellar, and so that's probably why I was like leaning away from it. So yeah, so it used to be that strength gave 0.2 and range got 1 in this like arbitrary scale. Now it's the case that they both give 1. So what is that? That's like 30% more effective now. So just for starters, it'll be 30% more effective, just from strength, like just from the strength component, because strength is now. What is it? Strength is now 5 times as powerful, whereas it had previously only been a sixth of the overall component. So yeah. Oh wow. 1 a.m. Where is 1 a.m.? That I mean, that's got to be. Yeah, where is it? What time zone is that? I mean, like, I'm not good at geography, but. I'm trying to picture what's there, and all I'm picturing is the Atlantic Ocean, right? Oh, the UK, really? Oh, okay. Huh. Oh, okay, sure. Yeah, for some reason. Okay, yeah, for some reason I thought it was I thought it would be further like further west than that. But yeah, okay, cool. wow, you're that's some dedication right there. Yeah. 5+. Okay, yeah. For some reason I was thinking like 4+, but I'm apparently just bad at mental math. Like I said, arithmetic, take it or leave it. Range, yeah. And then I keep forgetting to tune down the explosion radius unless I actually remember, unless I actually do it. So yeah, last time I cut it in half and I found that that was too dramatic, and then I ended up boosting it up a little bit. So I'm gonna try like, it was at 0.4, I'm gonna try 0.25, which is pretty close to half. But the other thing I did was to increase the base range, so it'll reach a further distance, which would have given it a bigger radius just because of how that math works. But now I'm toning down the radius pretty significantly. So you'll still be able to snipe with bombs from the very start, but in fact you'll be able to snipe better because you'll be able to snipe a further distance. But hopefully this will tone down on some of the gratuity in the explosions that we were seeing before. Basically, it's tomato juice, so it's not sauce, but yeah, other than that, you're basically correct. So what should I do now? I'll try stacking on Dash again, I guess. Dash, dash, stacky, stacky. Boom. What? Oh no. I apparently did not calculate the strength correctly. 'Cause that is not a strong. Oh my gosh, it's not even hitting the minimum. There's technically a minimum amount of knockback that must be applied in order to knock a cookie out of a mop's hand, or knock a coin out of a mop's hand. Wait a second, what? He was definitely getting thrown into the air. Okay. Well, so, alright, well, that's interesting. It reveals another unintended consequence, or it reveals an unintended consequence of another system that I implemented. But, yeah, for some reason, the values that I mean, they were all part of the same calculation, and I multiplied one by five, and I divided the other by five, but apparently that was not, those were not equivalent. Alright, hold on. So for one thing, apparently, I guess just boost this back up a little bit. Whoa, how did you get zeroed? You're not zero, you're, .04? Yeah. Well, I guess that would explain it. Wait, but if you were zero, then how were you giving any explosion force? Alright, so that's weird. Bomb explosion might have been a little... No, that was probably... Bomb explosion was probably fine. Alright, so... Then, yeah, the other thing. So, knockback calc. Knockback calc. Go to declaration. Yeah, so right. So we have the min drop. KB min drop. So instead of KB dot magnitude, let's say mob's health. Mobs. Just because of the way we're calculating this now. Mob's health. MI. Because, yeah, KB, knockback, like, the actual knockback force applied has a lot less to do with how far mobs go flying anymore. Now it has a lot more to do with, what their health is at. If all I had to eat was a thing of spaghetti sauce, I would eat a thing of spaghetti sauce. And by all I had, what I mean is, like, if I hadn't gone to the store, and, like, literally all there was on my shelf, I would eat an entire thing of spaghetti sauce before I went to the store to get a new thing of anything, before I went to get any food for myself. No, that's not true. I'd order a pizza. Because I'd look at the spaghetti sauce, and I'd be like, ooh, that reminds me of pizza. I'd think about eating it, but then I'd be like, Actually, part of the reason I keep thinking about, like, how long I've been streaming is because I keep thinking, maybe I should just cut out early and then go buy a bunch of, like, ice cream and just spend the rest of the night eating ice cream. And, that's also part of why I keep deciding, no, I should stream a little while longer. Because I know as soon as I stop, that's exactly what's going to happen. It's just a matter of time. I mean, I really shouldn't. But that rarely stops me, unfortunately. Maybe I won't. Maybe I'll find the strength within myself to resist. Huh. Dash radius seems really big. I mean, I guess I did put a lot of points into range, but... Maybe I'm just not used to seeing it that big, because I haven't been putting a lot of points into range recently. I can probably scale it down a little more, though. Yeah, and part of the reason I want to tone down range is that it's power, but it detracts that power directly from, like, the skill necessary to play the game. Like, it's not, like, the type of power that makes the game more fun. It's the type of power that, like, works almost exactly contrary to that. I think I'm gonna start hoarding modifiers, so that way once how 3 shows up, I can start stacking on it directly, and I'll have some saved up. Kind of like what I did with Dash. Yeah, pro tip, Dash is always the 6th one to spawn. So if you put bombs on your bar, you can keep 5 modifiers, or you can keep 4 modifiers in your top bar, and still take bombs when it, or still take Dash when it's peeking in from the corner. So if you like stacking on Dash, then boy do I have the strategy for you. Although, yeah, one of the risks of stacking on POW 3 is that I'm not clearing the board nearly as fast as I would be if I use those. Yeah, POW 3. If I'd been using those modifiers sooner. So I'm wondering if that'll bite me in the end. Wow. Alright. So there's at least one really fun thing about stacking on POW 3 after having stacked on Dash, is that it makes Dash so good. Look at this Dash. Hold on. Once Dash comes back, I'll do it. It is the Uber Dash to end all Dashes. So that's kind of cool. The other interesting thing about... Yeah, it was... I mean, we definitely have to keep the power of bombs under control, because the thing about stacking on anything other than bombs is that they still have, like, a pretty long cooldown, so you really have to, in order to stay alive between those cooldowns, you have to either just clear the board so effectively, or you still have to rely on bombs for stuff like, sniping and whatnot. Yeah. Never gonna get bored of that one. Yikes. This is risky. Or it feels dangerous because I don't know. Maybe it was just because I just stacked on bombs. So, like, I was so used to having, like, a oh-no button, like, available, like, at basically all times. But now, like, I don't know. It's probably... Like, I think the power level of the modifiers is probably, overall, it's probably still slightly high. Because, like, I'm not exactly, like, going crazy or anything, but I'm, like, just having no trouble keeping all the explosives undetonated. So, I mean, another thing I could just do is to decrease the detonation timer. If, like, because, like, right now it takes 10 seconds for them to detonate. And it might be... Yeah, there we go, victory march. It might be just better to have that quicken. I could even, I mean, one of the other things I talked about was having the detonation timers quicken later in the game. Although, I don't know. I don't have any specific plan. Oh yeah, so when I talk about, like, my games being, like, 80% done and still needing 20%, another thing would be audio. Yeah, so, right, like, leaderboards. Some way to post to social media. Friends lists, or, like, friends interaction, so that you can see where your friends are on the leaderboards. What else? Platform-specific features. Or platform, you know, platform integration. And, yeah, audio. Wouldn't that be cool? If the game had, like, any audio whatsoever. So the reason I haven't done it yet is because audio is very much not my strength. And, in fact, I find audio to be very, like, unnecessary to games. Like, there are games that do audio so well that it's, like, beautiful, really. I appreciate those games, but the games that I play on a regular basis, I usually have the sound muted, because I'm usually listening to music or doing something else instead in the background. Oh, yeah, that would be cool. Like an early 90s vibe, like, Do you remember like late 80s, early 90s, like how synth was like all over the place? Like I don't know. I feel like that would be fun. Like make like the soundtrack to the game like completely like new wave. I don't know. Yeah. So yeah, I have no I have like well, so one of the cool things is that the studio I used to work at made music games, so I know like so many sound designers that like if I like whenever I want to, I basically just have like a long list of people that I could like the first time I start like when I started posting about my portfolio projects, like the first day like I got several different of my like former coworkers like or colleagues just like you know people I know they were like hey I noticed you don't have sound design for your game yet and I was like so yeah for a finished product I would very much like that like to have that so yeah if you if and when I put these live then yeah thank you I really appreciate that you guys do 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 if I use that for the soundtrack, I probably I'm sure I can't license it, but if I could, I would have a mob appear on each of the do 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 do. Yeah. Oh, I mean, oh, sorry. What I was saying though, before I got distracted, was yeah, cool. I don't know. I guess like I've only really been showing these games to like people I know and like friends and family like that. Like I haven't been loud about it yet. And so I don't know. It's just cool that like. We have fun here, right? I do at least. I'm glad to hear that you guys are having fun as well. yeah, it's just I don't know, it's really cool. I haven't had like random people or not to imply that you're random, but I mean like, you know, like people who have no like obligation to be nice to me, to just like randomly be nice. So I very much appreciate that. Thank you guys for checking out the games too. Like I said, I just I don't know. It's like it's yeah, I'm gonna say like just like playing games and like the part where like you actually get like the human experience of like you know someone's played your game and here's how they here's what they think about it or here's how they feel about it like yeah I'm gonna say that would be the most fulfilling it's got to be the most fulfilling part of the of game development at least for me I think I should increase power on the hero, because it used to be that the hero's auto attacks were overpowered, but it was because of range, not because of power. So I think I could boost the hero's auto attacks, and I could, like I was saying, I could boost the whoa. Why is dash? Oh, yeah. I think I'm gonna take the dash. Range down. Yeah, that's why the dash range feels big because I took it down, and then later I increased the base range. So it like in effect it like went back up. So instead of 21, I'm gonna say like 17. Yeah, right. Yeah, that's why I like it. I like that. I mean. I don't know, for some reason it never occurred to me that like everyone who watched game dev streams would themselves be game devs. But this is like way cooler than I could have expected because now it's like I don't know, we're like a mini collective of like of game devs. We all have like I mean, maybe not the exact same goals, but we're all like working towards similar things. So like we all have like we all have cool perspectives that we can share and just all this stuff. Oh yeah, so you get an ally by putting a multiplier on your hero. So like just like you just like with all the other modifiers, you can so yeah, whenever you get a modifier, you can put it on one, any of your powers if you have powers. Or you can put it on this brick here, and this represents your hero. So if you put a strength one here, your hero gets stronger. If you put a range one, if you put a range one here, your hero's range increases. You can increase your hero's speed, and then yeah. So the plus sign is the one that affects multiplicity, and yeah. Originally, oh, fun fact. Originally, allies were going to be POW 3. And the way you would get allies would be by activating POW 3, and each time you activated it, you would get an ally. And they would only last for a limited period of time. Oop, almost let that one detonate. But yeah, once I came up with the idea of the modifier system, it occurred to me that, like, oh, I could add one in for multiplicity, and that's how I could add in new allies. Yeah, but what did I say I was going to change? Okay, I did change the radius of. I changed the radius of dash again. I have not yet changed the strength of the hero. So the initial strength is 12 and it increases by 3. So let's try like 15 and increase by 5. And then oh yeah, so let's put that. I had these like separate values for the allies, but I'm gonna try having them with full values. With full hero values for a little while, just to see how that goes. So yeah, let's literally give them the same stats as the hero. Yeah, there we go. And then, oh right, then there are the scalers for ally mod scales. So, oh wow. Wow. Yeah, I did not boost them the same way I boosted the hero. So you're all going to one for now. And then if that's overpowered, then I can revisit. I don't think it will be, as long as I'm keeping range under control. And by range specifically, I mean, where is it? Oh. Oh, I must have left it somewhere else. Oh yeah, here we go. Hero range radius scale. And actually, I did increase the hero's range recently, so I'm actually going to take it down to from instead of 0.07 to 0.055. I also, oh, sorry, I was just catching up on chat. My friend, I haven't played Alien Isolation myself yet, but my friend, who's really big into horror, played it, and I think she said she had a good time. She literally, she was up at midnight just to download it as soon as it was available, and yeah, I've never been big on horror games. I can play them, but like. I spend my time more annoyed than anything, which I know that's weird, but like horror games affect you like like horror in general affects you like in a physiological manner. Like it makes you more nervous and it makes you anxious, and so like because I don't know. For some, like I re my I like reject that on some level. Like I psychologically just reject it, such to the point that I basically anything like any anxiety that I feel from playing the game, I like redirect it back at the game in the form of annoyance. And so like my friend when there's like a promo for the next there's like a well, in case anyone hasn't played it and they want to play it, I won't talk about what it is, but like I forget what it was called. It was like a two it was like I forget what the game was called, but it was basically like this demo or like this short like free game that once you played through to the end of it, like it was a horror game, and once you played through the end of it, it revealed something at the end, which I'll just speak very vaguely about it. And my friend, well, so anyways, I can tell you right now that would not go well if I tried to. Well, no, maybe that would be okay. I would probably make, if I tried to live stream a horror game, I would probably be okay, but no one would stay and watch because it would just be me yelling at the whatever I was playing, like the console or the computer, the whole time. It would just be shouting. It would just be incessant shouting. Yeah, that's the one. Yep. PT. Or yeah. And so my friend loves horror games, and I guess I hadn't. It was someone that I'd met relatively recently, but had become like fast friends with, and they did not know about me. This is just like rejection of horror games that is just inherent in my person, and so they were trying to get me to play it, and I was like, okay, I'll give it a shot. And at a certain point, there's like this annoying like breathing noise that just happens all the time. No, it doesn't happen literally all the time. It's like if you stop moving, this awful breathing noise like kicks in, and like it's just like, I mean, it's supposed to be like creepy or whatever, but I got over that. I got over the creepiness really fast, and then it was just like this horrible, horrible noise. And like, there aren't very many games that will literally, there aren't very many genres wherein the games will literally try and torture the audience. Like, not horrible torture, like, it's just exposure to this terribly uncomfortable noise, like, which is literally a form of, like, very mild torture. And I let the game know exactly how I felt about that. And I didn't end up making it very far. I made it pretty far, but just through some combination of like my sheer displeasure for everything the game had to offer, and I might have overdone it with strength. I think I'm maxing out strength prematurely. I don't know. It's a little hard to tell. I guess I'm not actually one-hit killing them or anything, but So after like after a half hour with that game, my friend eventually realized that it was not going to get any better. I bet if you liked horror games, though, it would probably be a very enjoyable experience. Yeah, that was the other thing, is that part of my defense mechanism against anything horror is to make it a joke. And so I had a very difficult time taking the game seriously, and I made up my own narrative, and I think that was part of what my friend didn't, I think that was part of where we were not on the same page, is that he didn't enjoy the story about the forgetful bottle collector who doesn't enjoy sweeping. Because like there's just so much set dressing, like they, I don't know, they put like, they, I think they like put a lot of time into right, yeah, because as soon as it's ridiculous, then it no longer like carries any like threat. So I don't know, they just put like, it was such a contained area, like it was, you know, the whole game took place in or at least as much as I played of it took place in this this, you know, this relatively small space, and then and then So it's, I don't know. I like there are like bottles on the floor that it's, I don't know, just like so much of what the game actually wanted you to focus on was so like curious and out of the way that like the anything like you would say to or anything I came up with basically to kind of like mock the experience, I guess technically. I was like it was I was making a bit of a mockery of it, whatever. I don't know, it made about as much sense to me. Like horror and like the psychological supernatural is kind of literally ridiculous by definition. So I feel like something's gone terribly wrong with this strategy, but I don't know what it is. Like, look at the population. But we're not like in the victory rush. Either I hit like a weird bug, or I don't know. Oh, that's about. I didn't see anything detonate. Maybe I just wasn't paying attention. I was getting a little bit chatty. I feel like this is a higher score than I've ever gotten. Not like total score, but like, oh, here we go. Huh. Come on, get out of here. Go. Oh, well, so one thing I should do is change how, All right, so maybe. Oh, no, I think I know what was happening. Yeah, I forgot to change how knockback works on auto attacks. All right. Yeah, right? Yeah. So actually getting a higher base score like without the time bonus, it seems kind of counterintuitive, but that's technically not a good thing. Because in order to get that many points, it means you had to have the simulation running for a long time, which means you should get a lower time bonus. So it's kind of weird. Which is why I was thinking of changing the time bonus thing to like a graded system instead. So that way, I don't know. I mean, the other thing I could do is on the end game screen, I could just show the score and the time. And that way people could like they could kind of like choose their own goal. I think like the diehards oh, sorry, I wasn't following in along chat very much throughout that. I only got three multipliers that whole time. I mean, I did really bring the scale down on multipliers, so I guess that makes sense. Huh. Sorry, yeah, I wasn't keeping up my chat. Yeah. Yeah. It's I'm not above drinking straight Ragu, but I am not at this current juncture doing so. So yeah, at a certain point I realized I'd been talking about oh hold on, I'm gonna I realized I'd been talking about that one experience with that horror game that one time. And I was talking about that for a while. Oh wow, okay, so yeah, previously, wow, this one was even from when the max number of mobs was 1,000, and here it was It was only like, oh, did I change that? I think I changed that, right? I changed it down to, yeah, 800. And even then, it took me an additional like almost a minute more. Yeah, like a minute more to clear.